Good morning, everyone. It's August 23rd. As many of you know, this is a special day for me because it's my birthday. And one of the best presents I got this morning when I woke up is that the company that's been putting together our pews and refinishing them and refurbishing them made this delivery this morning. So now we have all of the pews from the two middle sections that are now in the church, as I explained at Mass this weekend. And our guest for this week is Bob Ripley. He works with the Keck Group out of New York, and I wanted Bob to be with us today to explain to all of you what the process has been. So welcome to our video,
thank you
for all your hard work,
thank you.
If you could share with everyone, we'd really appreciate that.
Thank you. You're welcome. Okay, good morning, everyone, and I just want to give you a little rundown of the processes when we remove pews out of a church, typically. First, it starts with the removal process, and we create a drawing similar to this one, right? And every pew in here is numbered to this drawing.
Right.
There's a second drawing back a few pages in the notebook here that shows the remainder of the church.
Right.
Now, every pew in here will have a number.
Right, right.
Okay?
The corresponding
to it. It's stamped in the base, a number such as this.
Right.
All right. That's all permanently stamped in the base, so we know where everything goes when it's returned back.
And then when you removed it, I remember you guys made your markings right along the walls and everything, right?
Yes.
Okay.
We make marks throughout the church to show the aisle lineup and the center aisle lineup, side aisle lineups, and shows where everything existed. Very important that we get everything back the way it was.
Right. And then, so that was step one. Step two was at your warehouse?
Yeah.
Or?
Yeah. And we remove everything. They go in tractor trailers, and then we'll unload everything into the warehouse. We have a rather large warehouse, and it starts at one end of the building, as you can imagine. There's a lot of steps.
Right.
First, the hardware all gets removed from the pews. Any existing kneeler hardware, any book racks, anything like that will be removed from the pews. At that point, they're going to be put into a stripping tray, okay, and a liquid paint remover is applied to the pews at that point. At that point, the finish is removed from the pew, then it's rinsed down, with just regular everyday water, and at that point, set out to dry, and that's just the beginning. The second step that
probably sanding
we move along to is sanding, of course.
Okay.
Everything gets sanded with sometimes 100 grit paper, but more often than not 150 grit sandpaper. All the repairs are addressed at that time. Any fills, any wood repairs, anything that's broken will get repaired at that time. Then we move on to the next step, which is going to involve staining the pew, whatever color is selected.
And we love the color.
Yeah.
You guys are great in helping us do that. Yeah,
they look great in here.
Yeah.
And we'll stain the pews at that point, and we'll let that dry. It goes through a three-coat process. We'll spray everything with pre-catalyzed lacquer. All right, that'll seal it, and then it'll get sanded again, only this time with 220 grit sandpaper.
Wow.
A little finer.
Okay.
At that point, we apply the second coat.
Okay.
Then it will get sanded again, with a 320 grit pad.
Wow. And this is all by hand and everything?
All by hand.
Wow.
Everything by hand. And at that point, the third coat will get applied. Everything's set out to dry, after those steps. And then it gets prepared to be loaded. And at that point, they'll go through and check for any minor imperfections, fill anything that's not been taken care of in all the previous steps.
Right.
Into the truck it goes, and load blanketed and ready for shipment.
And then you bring it back here like you guys did, and then you snap your lines again.
We put the lines back as it was, and we line everything up and reapply all the hardware again that existed previous.
Right. And so what they were waiting for, I know some of you were asking why the first pews weren't drilled in already when they delivered them, is that it just makes a lot more sense to have all of the pews in place, because even if you're just a quarter of an inch off at the front, you'd wind up being like
inches.
8 inches off the back.
Yeah.
So they've snapped all of their lines, now they're here, and we're hoping by the end of the day on Wednesday that they'll have all of these main pews in the two main sections here. So that's awesome.
Ready
Thank
for
you.
Use.
Thank you so much.
You're
I
welcome,
appreciate
Father.
Bob.
Thank you.
And we'll say bye to everyone. Thanks for watching.
Bye-bye.
Bye.